What's going on, everybody? Today, I'm going to be talking about sockeye salmon fishing, and in particular, sockeye salmon fishing in Alaska on the Kenai Peninsula with the Kenai River and the Russian River, and talking about the gear selection and what you need to get out there and be successful when it comes to sockeye salmon fishing. Let's check it out. To start out, I've got the board here full of yarn and beads and different egg loop setups. So first of all, we'll start with the first thing here, which is the pre-tied leaders. So I was able to get some size three hooks from the store, some Gakamatsu hooks, and then this is 40-pound P-line fluoro clear line. And what I did to start to create these is make about 40 to 50 inch leader lengths and cut them, and then make the egg loops by doing 8 wraps first, running it through, and then finishing it with 6 more wraps. Doing these egg loops on the leader boards here are really easy, they're super efficient, and they're quick to just grab and go, especially with these sockeye. They fight really hard. And so you're gonna have to utilize a lot more gear than normal fishing. So having these quickly can get you back on the water and fishing super quickly. So I've got one example here. So for me, I like the length to be about 28 to 36 inches from hook to the end of the leader. Now, depending on your preference and water speed and where you're fishing, you may want a little bit longer of a leader, so 42 inches. When you pre-cut and tie these, you can always make them longer and then cut them shorter depending on who you're fishing with. So my wife likes a little bit of a shorter leader, so we go with about 28 to 30 inches. I like about 36 for the most part. And from the weight to the end of your hook gives you just about the right length. For this one, just a quick egg loop. So I've got just the loop here, and this adds for a couple things that you can do. One is you can play around with your yarn and filter your yarn through here. And then you can cinch your yarn in, and then depending on your length, you don't want the yarn too long, because eventually if it gets wet, it'll get caught in your hook, and so that's, you're not catching fish if the yarn's in the hook. So if you get a little bit of a longer length of yarn, you can tie it a couple of ties. So for this one, I've got a shorter yarn, so I'm just gonna go one over and through and then tie that on there. And then then you got here, you shouldn't get into your hook or your barb, and that's about the right length for your yarn here underneath your egg loop. So nice and easy with that. And then the other way we like to fish is with a couple beads here. So I just looped it through the egg loop, put the beads here through the loop, and tie it underneath. So this is another way to do it. You can also add more yarn here. Again, also that adds more weight. So as you're plopping your hook and jig into the water, it may float a little higher or may dive a little bit deeper depending on the weight and the extra eggs that you've got on here. But for just standard, so here's my hook with my egg loop, and then I've got my line, and then tied to what we call a hot dog weight. So one end goes to your leader, and then your main line comes down to the other end of this tied through. We like to do it with a uni knot here at the top. So that's kind of just the standard, the way we do it from a looping perspective. Now, different types of yarn, different types of fishing and color conditions. So let's walk through that for a second. I've got black, I've got pink, and then we got Volt or Chartreuse here. You can also use orange as a good color. Now, depending on the color of the water and the speed and the conditions of the day. So right now the sun is out, and the water's a little bit off color from the sediment coming upstream from the glacier. So for today, we're actually fishing with the black yarn with the UV. And one of the reasons for that is with that off color, that black coming through the water stream, that fish will see it a little bit easier. On overcast days, when the water's a little bit off color, black's not necessarily the best color to use. But definitely bright sunny days in the middle of the day, clear conditions or a little bit off conditions, black is our favorite color of yarn to use in your egg loop. Now, pink and chartreuse just depends on how the fish are attacking the jig. We like to use these earlier in the morning when the sun is rising or the sun isn't fully up. It's a little bit brighter color within the water columns. The pink and the chartreuse will be a little bit brighter to those fish. So we like those when in the morning. Also, when the water is clear during the day, sometimes pink is really, really good, especially in those mid-afternoons when the sun is super bright and the water conditions are super clear. Chartreuse is another good one that any time of the day is good. In the evening time, chartreuse can be really hot of a color, just as that last bit of sun is shading over, that bright chartreuse can come through easily. So those are the three types of yarn that we like to use. We've also got some pre-tied yellow and orange here. That isn't a bad combination, especially now that it's the time of year in August. We have some coho running up and they will definitely bite on that orange and yellow. So we're gonna get a couple more different color combinations to utilize there. Now we've also got, going down the line here, we've got some double hook ties. Now depending on the regulations of where you're fishing, you can fish double hook jig setups. Today we cannot do that. So it's the regulations only allow for one hook unbaited with real bait. But these can be deadly effective too when fishing for sockeye. The other way that we like to fish is with these fly hooks. So it's a fly tied to the top here with a short, with a little bit of a longer hook, but a shorter curl than the Gakamatsu hook. So just for comparison here, this is a size 3 Gakamatsu, and then this is a fly hook setup. So this is really good when you're fly casting and fly fishing here in the Kenai. Really easy to cast these. I've got a little bit of a weight on the end here to get that fly down in front of the fish in its face. Colors wise, we like the pink and yellow, but also again, chartreuse and even black in those days where the water's a little bit off color are super deadly effective. These flies, we've caught a ton of sockeye on over the years. One of the best setups besides the egg loop hook that we do. Deadly jig when you're talking about sockeye fishing on the Kenai for reds. We come down here, I showed you the egg loops earlier. We just use Brad's eggs. Again, you can do different colors. There's different oranges, especially in the later part of the season when you're maybe fishing for coho. Orange eggs underneath a bobber or just orange eggs on an egg loop are super deadly effective. Again, these are one of my favorite jigs and beads to use as well. Now a couple other, one last thing here. So we've got, this is the, these are Brad's pre-ties. You can get these in the packages at the store. These are cut at about 42 inches with 40 pound size 5 hooks. Now these are massive hooks. Size 2 or 3 is probably better size hooks to utilize. But if you're in a hurry and need a pinch, these are easy to use and grab on the go. Again, cut your leader length down depending on who's fishing and how you like it. I would go with the 40 pound at the minimum if you're going 50 pound. They come in 8 packs, which is great, but if you're running through them super quickly, you might switch to making your own if you've got some time. Now, in terms of weight size, I've got more hot dog weights here. So a couple different sizes. So here I've got a 1 ounce. And when I would use a 1 ounce is when the river level is on the rise and it's a lot higher than normal. So this is in fast conditions, the one ounce of getting that your leader down into the water is super, super critical. So that's what I usually, when I use a 1 ounce here, my go-to is the 3/4 ounce here in the middle. That's kind of just in all conditions. For me, gets the jig down right away. You'll bounce it a little bit off the bottom, and then as you come straight up with that fly technique, usually gets that jig right in the front of that fish so they snap right on it and hook them right in the side of the lip. 3/4 is the standard that I would go with if I'm gonna fish weights. Now, I've also got a 5/8 here, which I think for kids and most of the ladies is a good size weight. It still gets your leader down right in that strike zone, as well as when the conditions are a little bit slower than normal, like it is today. 5/8 is super deadly as well. So you can go 3/4 or 5/8. You can go to a 1/2 ounce, but you'd have to have the water going much, much slower than normal. I wouldn't advise against a 1/2 ounce, but unless you've got some weight like you would with your fly hook that's getting that down right into the strike zone, you can get away with a 1/2 ounce with the water conditions as they are today. 1/2 ounce is probably not getting your jig right in that strike zone. It's probably having it float up a little bit higher in the water column, and so you're gonna catch less fish that way. So 5/8 and 3/4 are my go-to from a weight perspective.
Now, one additional piece of gear that you might add into your selection for sockeye salmon fishing are these sockeye fly rigs from Kodiak Custom Tackle. Now, they've got gear that you can buy online as well as in locations around the Kenai Peninsula. In Soldotna in particular, we go to the Soldotna Trustworthy Hardware Store and they'll have these sockeye fly rigs, and they're easy to use, simple to set up. So if you're strapped for time or just want something really simple and easy to use for sockeye salmon fishing, whether on the mainstream lower Kenai River or up on the Russian River, try some of these sockeye fly rigs. Now these sockeye fly rigs are pre-tied with hooks in your fly right here, and comes in about four different colors: yellow, pink, orange, and blue. And depending on the water color and conditions that you're fishing, each one of these flies can be super deadly in terms of catching your limit of sockeye salmon for the day. Now it comes with 5.5 feet of leader line here, all the way to a three-way swivel with a little dropper duo snap, which you just attach your weight to. So as you're fishing this, you'll have your main line coming from this open circle here, then your little dropper weight here, probably about 1 ounce or 5/8 or 3/4, and then your leader line here all the way to your fly. So as the weight is dragging along the bottom, that fly is in the strike zone and the sockeye will go after this. And again, if you're somebody who's looking for something new to put into your gear selection for sockeye, or if you just want to save yourself time, get some of these sockeye fly rigs. They're less than $3 and they're really easy to rig up and use, and you will catch more sockeye salmon with these sort of rigs. I like the chartreuse yellow and the pink is my two go-to colors for fishing these sockeye fly rigs from Kodiak. And if you haven't ever checked them out before, go online, check out the other gear that they've got, and pick yourself up some sockeye fly rigs for sockeye salmon fishing on the Kenai Peninsula. Thank you guys for watching the video today. Now, whether you're a regular, someone who's gone up once or twice, or looking to go up sockeye salmon fishing on the Kenai Peninsula, hopefully this video gave you guys some tips and some information on how to be successful when it comes to your gear selection and what you need to sockeye salmon fish in Alaska. Thank you guys for watching the video, and as always, everybody, the outdoors is a gift. Share it with others.